It's a beautiful day in this neighborhood, a beautiful day for our neighbor. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? It's a neighborly day in this beauty woods, a neighborly day for our beauty. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? I have always wanted to have a neighbor just like you. I've always wanted to live in this neighborhood with you, so let's make the most of this beautiful day. Since we're together, we might as well say, would you be mine? Could you be mine? Won't you be my neighbor? Won't you please? Won't you please? Please won't you be my neighbor? Hello, television neighbor. We're back together again, and I'm very happy of that. See what I brought today? A picture of a hotel and two race cars. Before we have some make-believe, there's somebody at the door already. Why, it's Mr. McFeeley.
Ha! Hector! It's good to be back. I was on sabbatical, you know. You know what a sabbatical is?
What?
Taking a break, a timeout. But I'm back now. How are you?
I'm good.
Have a seat. Who's that little guy there?
It's Mr. T.
Oh, hello, Mr. T. I'm Mr. McFeeley.
I hear you have a video for us in picture.
Oh, I have several videos. I have videos of your father feeding a little wild rabbit right out of his hand. I have videos of you doing magical things in the neighborhood of make-believe. I've got all sorts of videos. Which one would you like to see?
Well, let me tell my television neighbors first.
Mr. T?
Mr. McFeeley has a film that shows how to make toy bird houses.
Oh, that one!
In the factory.
Yes. That's one of my favorites.
So, why don't we put it in the picture? You could tell us all about it.
Okay.
So let's put the film in the picture.
Oh, there we go. I put it in.
And see how people make toy bird houses in the factory.
I'll flip the switch, and here comes our picture movie. And as you can see, the first thing to do is to design the birdhouse, because lots of people have lots of great ideas about what a birdhouse should look like. Some people think they should look like houses that people live in, for example. Other people think they should look like bird nests. I mean, there are all sorts of different things. So first you have to do a drawing, and then once you figure out, okay, now how do I cut the pieces of wood to fit that drawing, then you have to lay out all your pieces on a piece of wood and draw the lines. Then you have to get your jigsaw and you make all sorts of cuts and curves and curly cues and everything else and all the pieces of wood that you need. Then you have to take your little nails and your glue and your screws and you put it all together. Then you gotta paint them, you know, because birdhouses have to be painted.
Excuse me, Mr. McFeeley.
Yes.
What are these people doing in here?
Oh, these people over here, they're sanding down the birdhouses to make sure we have a nice smooth texture for the paint.
And what is this man doing here?
Oh, that's quality control. He's inspecting to make sure that these birdhouses are fit for aviary habitation.
You mean these toy birdhouses?
Oh, these are not toys. These are going to be used for little tiny birds. Yes, I know they look like they're toys, but believe you me, Victor, when we're done, we're going to have occupants in these little toy birdhouses. Little hummingbirds, goldfinches, all the little birds, the little tiny birds.
Well, thank you so much for showing this film on Picture Picture.
Oh, you're very welcome. It was my pleasure. See you later.
All right.
Bye.
Well, now that Mr. McFeeley had shown us the toy bird house factory on Picture Picture, why don't we have some make-believe? Alright. Now, last time in the neighborhood of make-believe, we were pretending that Charles R. Aber was talking with Queen Sarah and King Friday how to make toy birdhouses. So let's just pretend that Queen Sarah has already put the finishing touches with her husband, King Friday. So let's make believe more about that now, shall we? As the trolley goes by the castle garden in the neighborhood of make believe. Right, Charlie? Okay. Charles R. Aber, Westwood, Bird House Designer, I presume?
Oh, yes, Your Highness. Some people think I look a lot like Mr. McFeeley, but he just looks a lot like me but doesn't have glasses.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm Charles Aber.
Oh, dear. We're so pleased with all your hard work in the neighborhood of make-believe.
Oh, thank you, Your Highness. I so enjoy putting together those small little toy birdhouses that most people think are merely toys, but really they are future homes of hummingbirds and goldfinches.
Now...
And maybe an occasional titmouse.
Now tell me, dear, are you enjoying your line of work?
Oh, Your Highness, I could not be happier. You know, it's a young boy's dream to grow up and be able to do what he loves to do the best, and my dream came true.
Well, we hope to see you again on our next show, dear.
Well, thank you, Your Highness.
Bye, Charlie. Well, Charles R. Aber sure learned a valuable lesson on how to take care of bird houses. But before I leave today, I would like you to see a real live actor. I know a friend of mine who is delighted to show around his motion picture studio of Lemony Snicket, a series of unfortunate events. So come along with me, and we can meet the one and only Jim Carrey. You and I together. Jim, it's
Victor.
Victor.
Yeah, welcome back, buddy. Long time no see. Where you been?
Oh, I've been in my television neighborhood.
Oh, what you doing there?
Well, we.
Oh, that was so silly. I know what you do in the neighborhood. You're Victor Sprenkle of Victor Sprenkle's neighborhood.
Yes.
And you do all sorts of nice videos for young children to help them grow up.
Yes.
Yeah, I was just kidding. You know I'm a comedian, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Some people think I look a little like Charles Aver or Mr. McFeeley, but the truth of the matter is, even though they look a lot like me, they don't wear their glasses on top of their head. In fact, Mr. McFeeley doesn't even have glasses. Yes, sir.
It's so good to meet you, Jim.
Oh, it's nice to see you again, too. You forgot you met me once before.
Do we have time to visit?
Of course we do.
I've been hearing a lot of good things about you.
Oh.
And I was wondering, Mr. Carrey,
yeah.
How old did you start to act in movies?
Well, when I started acting in movies, I was 6 months old.
Jasmine.
Because my parents were movie stars, and they took me with them to the movie studio. And so when I was only 6 months old, I had a scene where I was in a crib crying to be filmed. Most people don't know that, though. And, you know, the credits went by so quickly, and I wasn't a star yet that, you know, nobody really noticed, but I can show you that someday. I'll show you the credits. Yeah.
Now
the baby in crib.
Now
James Carey.
Now, how did you get started in Lemony Snicket, a series of unfortunate events?
Well, as I was growing up, those were my favorite books because they had all sorts of problems that came up for us little kids. And so when I heard that they were going to make a movie out of the Lemony Snicket and the series of unfortunate events, I said, "Can I be in it? Can I be in it?" And I tried out for the role, and son of a gun, I won.
And I heard
I beat Leonard Nimoy. Leonard Nimoy wanted to do it, and they almost gave him the part.
And I heard.
Died.
I'll see you tomorrow, but I gotta get back to my place.
All right, we'll see ya. Always a pleasure, Victor.
You know, being sweet is trying to find out how much you love somebody, and when you become sweet to other people and you feel better in the world, you can feel sweet about it too. It's such a good feeling to know you're alive. It's such a happy feeling. You're growing inside, and when you wake up ready to say, "I think I'll make a snappy new day," it's such a good feeling, a very good feeling, the feeling you know that I'll be back when the day is new, and I'll have more ideas for you, and you'll have things you want to talk about. I will too. Bye.
Yay, that was a